campaign. I remember it vividly, particularly the wonderful ads, attack ads, aimed at him by his Democrat enemies.
Well, you know, it's an interesting thing, because we were talking last week about the anniversary of Freedom Summer and this critical moment for civil rights, but this is equally an important anniversary for the American right. Senator Barry Goldwater of Arizona won the Republican nomination for president in 1964, and he did so on the back of an insurgency within the Republican Party. Up until then, the Republican Party in the U.S. had been equally divided between sort of pro-business conservatives, a few John Birchers on the far right, and moderate and liberal Republicans, people from the Northeast, people like Nelson Rockefeller, the governor of New York, or Prescott Bush, the Republican senator from Connecticut and father of the first President Bush, who was the best friend Planned Parenthood ever had in the U.S. Senate, a great champion of birth control and a great champion of reproductive rights. So the Republican Party was this, and the technocratic moderation of Dwight D. Eisenhower had dominated the Republican Party. And through much of the 50s, in 1964, the conservative wing, and not just conservative, but the sort of pro-business libertarian wing, backed Barry Goldwater in his nomination speech at the Republican convention that famously said, "Extremism in the cause of liberty is no vice," and articulated for the first time the kind of libertarianism